explorers who may find the path and ballot box blocked or filled with obstacles, live right here in the state of Florida. Senator Bill Nelson approached me and asked me to hold this field hearing because of his concern that constitutionally protected rights to vote are under attack. Today's hearing is the first ever field hearing of this subcommittee. For the record, the Republican members of the committee were invited to attend. As well, they were given an opportunity to present witnesses. They have suggested witnesses who will be on the first panel considered by the subcommittee here. I want to thank Senator Nelson for his concern and advocacy on this issue, which I share, and I'm happy that he is with me today. We will hear from today's witnesses about HB 1355. It made a number of changes in Florida's voting laws. First, cutting the number of early voting days almost in half from 14 to 8. Second, eliminating early voting on Sunday before the election. Third, requiring third-party organizations that register voters to register with their state and meet an array of onerous administrative requirements that face hefty fines of hundreds or even thousands of dollars. Requiring Florida residents who have moved within the state and are updating their addresses at the polling site to vote a provisional ballot. For the record, more than 40% of the provisional ballots were not counted in our last election. Governor Rick Scott signed HB 1355 into law last year in Florida. In September of last year, I sent the governor a letter asking whether he planned to take any action to ensure that HB 1355's new restrictions would not disenfranchise legally able voters in Florida. To date, the governor has not responded to my letter. I also invited Governor Scott to attend this hearing today, hoping he would come personally to explain his support for HB 1355 and answer the questions raised by the law. I'm disappointed that he won't be able to join us. Governor Scott, our designated representative of his administration, accepted our invitation. We would have an opportunity to answer some pretty important questions. With the provision of HB 1355 that eliminates early voting on Sunday before election, specifically targeted to reduce the turnout of African-American and Latino voters, who make up an overwhelming number of voters who show up on Sunday before the election, did the Florida legislature anticipate that HB 1355's new administrative requirements for third-party voter registration groups and the threat of fines imposed would force groups like the League of Women Voters, Rock the Vote, and the Boy Scouts, as well as other respected organizations, to suspend their nonpartisan voter registration drives? Why does HB 1355 require Floridians who attempt to update their addresses on election day to cast provisional ballots, a large percentage of which are not counted in the final result? I am pleased, though, Governor, if you could not attend, that we do still have a distinguished panel of two panels of witnesses who will provide insight. Before recognizing Senator Nelson for an opening statement, I'm going to ask consent for the record for him to participate in today's hearing and make it clear and defend my practice in Washington to invite senators, even if they're not members of the committee or subcommittee, but have an intense personal interest or local interest in the issue to participate. So this is not a new approach, but for the record, I'm asking consent for participation of Senator Nelson, and without objection, he's recognized. Senator Nelson.